Georgia O'Keeffe is one of the American masters. Her works of art are a non-renewable resource, obviously. To be able to realize our artistic legacy going forward with this particular artist, we need to make sure that these works of art are protected for the generations to come. We started looking at them and realized that they were soap protrusions, which means that free fatty acids within the binding media of the paint reacted with lead and zinc pigments, started to aggregate, push the surface of the paint up, forming what looked like acne on the paintings.
For our project with the Georgia O'Keeffe Museum, we're making 3D surface measurements of the Georgia O'Keeffe's paintings. It's much easier to be able to identify these surface shape protrusions when you're looking at just the surface shape itself, and you can factor out the effect of the color of the pigment. And that's something that our techniques allow you to be able to do. We use these mobile devices, like a phone or a tablet, and in principle the idea is that you can wave this phone or the tablet in front of the painting. The light source on the mobile device reflects off the painting surface and then gets captured by the camera. And then that image information is then processed to be able to extract the surface shape information in a way that's independent of any of the color of the pigments.
So we have this portable device, which is great. We can collect surface data. And then, of course, the question is, what does one do with this data? So the main objective of the Georgia O'Keeffe project is not just knowing, oh, okay, there is a protrusion here or there is not. We want to see, let's say, the density of the protrusions. We want to see the size of the protrusions. We want to extract useful statistics that can tell us quite a bit about, again, the way they were created and the way they're going to progress.
The best recommendations for where these paintings could actually be stored eventually is really dependent on the measurements we're trying to make. After we understand what sort of environmental conditions that they've been in, what sort of relative humidity, what sort of temperatures, whether they've been in direct sunlight contact, gives us a lot of information that we can then use to go back to a museum director, to back to a collection care expert, to say that this needs to be in a particular environment with a particular environmental conditions to be able to allow it to survive over a very long period of time.